Everybody's talking about ChatGPT. In this video, I'm going to share with you how you can specifically use ChatGPT to grow your coaching business. So this is a 5-part video series, and in this first video, I'm going to give you a lay of the land, an overview of what ChatGPT is, how you can use it to grow your business. I'm going to share some of the things to do and not to do, and some best practices that you'll use throughout this entire mini course. All right, let's dive into it, shall we? First and foremost, let's talk a little bit about why ChatGPT is such a useful and valuable tool. Now, if you've played around with it a little bit, you can see that it's somewhat addictive. So that's kind of cool that it's an enjoyable tool that you can use. You can really, I think, have some fun with it. But overall, in terms of productivity, in terms of business growth, what it really does for you is it can accelerate your progress. It can save you time and also save you money that you might have invested in an assistant or in an intern or something like that to do research for you. So ChatGPT is a great tool to lean on, and it's something you want to be careful of how you use it as well. And I'll get into a little more of that later on in this video. First of all, what is it? Well, people throw around this term, it's a language model, which I don't really understand all that well. So I'll explain it to you in more layperson terms. Essentially, ChatGPT has been trained, it's been exposed to, it's crawled a portion of the internet. Really, I think the last time it did so was in 2022, earlier last year. And it crawls the internet, about 10% of it only, by the way, and picks up information and learns, essentially is able to learn from what it crawls. And what it does when it learns from that is it's able to make associations, recognize patterns, put together information, basically gather information from all over the farthest reaches of the internet, though again, not all of the internet, just a portion of it, and pull it together to be a resource at your fingertips. So it's like think of it as a very, very fast librarian, someone that can go into the internet and find information from all over and pull it together and give you a synopsis or a report of what it's found. Now, that's really amazing, and that can definitely provide tons of ideas and resources and information, but it's also a little bit dangerous. That's what I want to get into before we dive into how you can use this for your business, is to talk about some of the limitations and problems with ChatGPT. When you ask a question of ChatGPT, first and foremost, it's super important to remember that it is limited in the information that it gathers. So it can be biased, it can be wrong. If you've ever typed in your own name or asked ChatGPT to write your own bio, as I'll share later, you'll find that it has a lot of mistakes because it may have pulled some old information from some forgotten, long forgotten corner of the internet that is no longer relevant or correct anymore. So you've got to be really mindful because ChatGPT makes a lot of mistakes. It has a lot of misinformation, and it's got bias built into it, although they don't like to admit that. So you cannot just use, copy paste what you get from ChatGPT. I wouldn't recommend it. Aside from the fact that there's some ethical concerns about it as well. We don't know where it's getting its information. We don't know who it's taking it from. So if you're planning to use ChatGPT to create copy, to create content, number one, you want to be mindful that you're editing that content thoroughly. And number two, that you're crediting that you're using ChatGPT. By the way, I use ChatGPT to come up with some of the ideas in this series, but everything that you're hearing from me right now is coming straight from my head. Just so you know. Now, before I dive into some of the nitty-gritty details about ChatGPT, let me invite you to like this video, subscribe to my channel, so you can learn about more awesome videos about how to grow your coaching business and grow yourself in the process. So one thing to think about, the way I think about ChatGPT, I'll say it that way, is that it's more about quantity over quality. I use it as a brainstorming tool, as a way to generate a volume of ideas or titles or concepts. I don't necessarily think it has the highest quality results, but what it does together with my brain, so us in partnership, I can use ChatGPT to provide a volume of ideas, and then I use my discernment to choose which of those ideas is worth fleshing out and pursuing even further. I wouldn't use ChatGPT for anything really important. I think that this is something that you can use to write social posts and blog posts and maybe a video like this, but I wouldn't use it for your thesis or to write your book. Why? Unless you give credit for it. I mean, if you want to be, you know, open about that and transparent. Because the fact is that we don't really know how ChatGPT operates in terms of plagiarism. You might be finding information that it's lifting, not entirely, because it usually, it changes things, it adjusts them, it melds it with other stuff, but it might be lifting material from somebody else. So you want to be really mindful when you're using ChatGPT or any AI about the source of where it's coming from, what it's saying, and whether it's even accurate or not. Right now, my camera person that's here with me, he just informed me that people are saying that ChatGPT is like what a calculator was to mathematics, ChatGPT is for language. And that's a pretty good assessment. You type in a formula, which is like a set of parameters, and from that formula, ChatGPT spits back a result. The only difference, I guess, or one big difference would be that it always spits back a different result, right? So you can put in the same prompts and twice, and you will get different results each time. So let's dive a little bit into how you can use ChatGPT. And then in the next four videos, I'm gonna dive into each one of those more fully. So the first way you can use it is to boost your brand. ChatGPT can write everything from bios to titles and subtitles to taglines to copy, all sorts of great things. I've used it many times now since I discovered it a few months ago to support me in creating material for myself and also for my coaching clients. ChatGPT is also great for marketing your programs. I've used it and my clients are using it to write copy, to write sales letters, sales pages, webinar outlines, to write event invitations, all sorts of things related to getting the word out about your products and services. Another way that you can use it is to prospect for speaking engagements. This was a really fun exercise I did, and I have a whole video, the fourth video in the series is about that. And then finally, you can use ChatGPT to prospect for actual clients as well. My clients and I have been using it to write call scripts, outreach scripts, to write templates for email outreach, one-on-one connection. So using it for marketing in a one-to-many format, but also using it in one-to-one. You can ask it to write specific emails and specific call scripts for you as well. Overall, ChatGPT is just a great resource and a great tool. And I invite you right now, before even going on to the next video, to open up a window in ChatGPT and just start to play. Just start to ask it questions, ask it about yourself, ask it what it knows about you already. Now, if you have a common name, you might want to give it some details, like, you know, give it, for example, I would ask instead of Michelle Villalobos, although my name's not that common, I might ask it Michelle Villalobos, who was born in 1974, who went to Dartmouth College, right? So I might give it a few details to let it know who I'm talking about, but I'd love for you to just take a peek in there and see what you see what you find about yourself, and hopefully you'll find really good information. And if you find misinformation, well, that's something to note. Now, you can fix that over time by doing what I'm gonna outline for you now in the second video, how to use ChatGPT to boost your brand. Let's go.